For those that don't know, the character Mulani from Genshin Impact is like one of the nicest, most positive characters in the entire game. There's even a part in one of her character trailers where Mulani's getting robbed by this other woman. And ultimately, Mulani befriends the robber and by the end of the day convinces the robber to no longer do evil things and instead become a good person. So it's always funny when terminally online weird people on Twitter.com are getting offended over non-issues. And in this context, when they're getting mad at something regarding Mulani, it's just that much more funny, given how I explained that she's just such a positive character. And with that explained for anyone who might not be familiar with Mulani, now we'll have the juxtaposition of going over to the weird part of Twitter. Because unfortunately, we have two different artists being harassed over their Mulani art. We'll start with this artist's color difference. Now, first take a look at some of their profile here over on their media tab on Twitter, and get an idea of the general color palette that they tend to use for all of their character art. With that in mind, we'll hop over to this recent art that they did of Mulani. Now, the good news is that this adorable art got over 50,000 likes. However, if we take a look at some of the quote tweets, we can see people insulting the artist. For example, this one saying, 48,000 likes on blatantly whitewashed artwork. This can't be real. As we already established, this is simply a color palette that the artist tends to use for all of their characters. And this person can't fathom that because they're terminally online and perpetually angry. At least people who harass artists like this person are finally getting a wake-up call that they're just a part of an angry and vocal minority. In another example, we have this person saying, "Can we bring back bullying?" implying that they want to bully the artist over their depiction of Mulani. And this person even claims to be a game designer slash artist, and that's how they treat other artists. Isn't that wonderful? Here's some of the responses they got to their tweet advocating people to bully color difference. And you can see a response from the OP there as well. Now moving on. Next one says, "The quotes are telling us not to bully the artist. I'd like to know how exactly valid criticism is considered bullying. Whitewashing a character even more than Hoyo is something that does need to be called out." It's really astonishing how these people don't realize how lame they sound. Being like, "Oh, we gotta call this out. Yeah, what are you gonna do, tweet about it? You gonna cry on Twitter?" And again, this person did nothing wrong. It's cute art of a cute character, and if you're mad at that, that says a lot about you. And then we'll take a look at two more examples here where these people are just raging at the artist. Yeah. Now, earlier on, I did mention that there's unfortunately two different artists recently getting harassed over their Mulani art, and the second one is Yomi here, who says, "Hi, so I drew Mulani in the Summertime Odyssey style. Honestly, she genuinely looks like a Pokemon character, like that animal on her arm kind of looks like Oshawott." And once again, we have some absolutely adorable Mulani art here that somehow some people actually got offended by. Because as we can see in a follow-up tweet, Yomi says, "Hello, I'm so sorry for the maracas. I didn't know it was an offensive stereotype. Here is a revised piece where instead of it, it's the Oshawott looking thing. I'm really sorry, I'm not that active anymore." So we can then presume that people were indeed complaining about the art over the maracas. And in a follow-up tweet, we can see Yomi posting one of the threads that was sent to them, where to no one's surprise, one of the terminally online Genshin boycotters had made a thread back on August 17th talking about how angry they are over Genshin Impact's new zone, Natlon. Oh, and also about the past zone, Sumeru, which if you've been following the channel for a while, you'll probably recall that I also covered that back when it was occurring. Because at that point in time, people were complaining about Sumeru before it was even out. Similar to what we saw happen more recently with Natlon. Of course, regarding Natlon, people are still complaining about it, and apparently still complaining about Sumeru as well. Yeah, these people seriously need new material. They've been complaining about similar things for literal years, and they've still accomplished nothing. On the bright side, many people would rally behind Yomi and defend them. For example, this tweet reading, "Dear, as a Colombian, maracas are a beautiful representation of one of the instruments we use most in Latin America, so please, you did nothing wrong with your precious drawing." However, they'd get a response from someone else who doubles down on it being a problem, to which that other person would respond, saying, "Hey, thanks for explaining. It's great that the artist is informed about Hawaii, but the artist just drew the object Mulani holds in her idol animations in the game. They weren't trying to represent a real Hawaiian person, just Mulani, as she's shown in the game." And yes, indeed, as you can see right here, that's the idol animation of Mulani that's being referenced from literally in-game. Furthermore, as we've discussed multiple times, Genshin Impact has numerous disclaimers in-game and even on social media, including their customer support teams, where they disclaim that Genshin Impact is just a work of fiction and is not made to represent reality. Yet still, despite that, these Twitter cop types will always try and find a way to have some sort of excuse to bully and harass others, all while trying to act like they're morally superior while they do it. More people would also defend Yomi. For example, this one saying, "How was the maracas an offensive stereotype? She has the maracas artist she dances with in one of her idol animations. I'm confused. How is that offensive? Yomi then repeating what they heard and saying that they don't want to offend anyone. And a response that is just absolute facts, saying she's from Natlon, not Hawaii. It sure is amazing how Twitter cops can't differentiate between fiction and reality, even with various disclaimers explaining such. Although, like I said before, I don't think they really care about that stuff anyways, and they just want an excuse to harass people and or are very desperate to try and get some sort of Twitter clout. Now, it is true that Genshin Impact does take some inspiration from the real world, but it's also true that it's not supposed to literally be the real world. Genshin Impact and Teyvat is supposed to be its own thing. For example, right here on screen, as you've been seeing with all of the gameplay shown in this video, that's Natlon. It's clearly not literally Hawaii, and anyone who thinks that's exactly what Hawaii looks like and is supposed to look like must be taking some crazy pills or something. In conclusion, at least both artists received tremendous support despite having to deal with some of those Twitter cops. And to see more of their adorable art, you can once again find them at Color Difference and Yomiyu Arts. Also consider liking and or subscribing to my channel if you enjoyed my coverage, and as always, thanks for tuning in. I'll see you in the next one.